the best entertainment in basketball. Before we get started, I want to give a quick shout out to WSS, our sponsor for this segment in the show, at Shop WSS or visit shopwss.com. They got all the shoes, man. It's crazy over there. Okay, in the studio today, we have a gentleman who can hoop, can act, model, musician. You know what I'm saying? All around, just cool guy, man. Ballers in the ballers world. Okay. Rome Flynn, welcome to the building.
Thank y'all for having me, man. Y'all turned up in here. Love it.
It be lit. What's it is lit. Hello? Well, man.
Got the Instagram live popping.
Instagram live popping.
Follow me, Rome Flynn.
Rome Flynn. Right.
I don't know. Can you hear me?
No, I can't hear you.
Okay.
I got you.
Rome. What's you're up? Also, I have six siblings, right?
Me?
She's like.
I want to know about, is that true?
She got six siblings.
Let me think. I think there's more than that, honestly.
Okay. Oh, yeah. So you're a family man.
I got family.
Papa was a Rolling Stone. What was that?
Man, you know, my mom was with my dad and she got remarried, you know, and then my dad got remarried, so he got his own kids.
Right.
So we basically got a whole basketball team.
That's lit.
So you're born and raised in Chicago.
Yep.
And so you started off playing basketball, right? In
that
high school?
Way. Yep.
So what happened with that? Do you have dreams to be a basketball player?
You know what? I don't know. I think I did it because I wanted to stay out the streets or whatever, you know, and I just kind of, I wasn't that great till I got after high school.
Wait, I'm going to say, you was an all-star.
I mean,
and
when I was.
Football.
No, I wasn't an all-star in football. I played football, but I wasn't an all-star in football. But in basketball, like my senior year, I was really good. But throughout, like, my freshman, sophomore year, I didn't make the team.
What? Oh, yeah.
They were mean as hell. Okay. No, but they were really good.
So what happened senior year?
Okay, so I grew up in Chicago, and then I moved to Springfield, Illinois, right? And I went to the school Andre Iguodala went to.
Ooh.
And, I mean, they had a lot of recruits coming there, a lot of, like, D1 talent coming there. So it was really hard to make the team there. And then my senior year, I just made it. Like, by the grace of God, I was working my ass off in the summertime and stuff like that. And I ended up fracturing my middle carpal bone in my left hand before my senior year. You know, so, and I had, like, a great summer year. I was averaging, like, over 20 points, and I had a lot of colleges looking at me, and then I fractured my hand, and then they kind of, like, fell off, like, you know, dead leaves on a flower.
Like, what colleges?
On a flower.
I don't really want to plug
that. Poetic ass. That was light skin, man.
You know, I really don't want to plug
like dead leaves on a flower. They just wilted and fell to the floor.
That was romantic.
Yeah,
was
man,
really
and it died right when it hit the ground.
That's his actor in him, man.
Oh, that's
man.
Just my artistic side, man.
And, man, and so, real quick, because I met you hooping,
yeah.
But then we were hooping. I'm like, okay, cool, yeah, light skin, we can hoop. That's what's up. Then I go out to Atlanta to visit my sister, doing Drumline 2, a new beat or whatever it was. And I'm like, hey, sis, and shout out Alexander Ship, my sister. All of a sudden, I look over. I'm like, hey, what's up, Hooper brother? What's going on?
I'm like, dog, that's so weird.
And so, how did you get into acting, man? Mm-hmm. What brought you out to L.A.? So we talked about Chicago and Hooper. How'd you get out here, man? What got there?
You know, it's just like I was at a point in my life where I wanted to figure out what I wanted to do, like every young person. And I was working at a pawn shop at the time, and I heard something on the radio. Oh no, baby, this is real. Listen, I worked hard for this, baby.
Shoot from the hook.
Okay,
shoot from the hip.
You gonna roast me? No, let me roast you. Let me think about what I want to say. Right. I'm gonna get you.
I'm gonna come back for that.
Don't roast you. Nah, but real talk though. No. So at a point, I was kind of at like a fork in the road, and I kind of stumbled upon acting. And then at the same time, after rehabilitating my hand, I got picked up by a college, Benedictine University.
Whoa.
And, you know, I had a scholarship. And then so at that point, it was either acting or a scholarship. And I kind of went towards acting, something with more longevity.
Yeah. It worked out a little bit, right?
I mean, I'm still hooping.
You were on some little show called The Bold and the Beautiful,
something
I think
like
it was
that.
Called. Yeah, right?
Why y'all say little?
Right. No, man. I definitely turned out, I mean, for myself, great. I mean, I definitely got more to do.
And, I mean, but you didn't have any connects when you started, did you?
No.
So what was it that got you where you are now? Like, what was it, the big role or the audition? Or what did you do? Did you go to class?
Like, no, you know, for me, man, it was like I always was kind of protective of my craft, you know. Mm-hmm. I didn't take any classes. I've only taken a few here, and, like, I work with specific people. But it's something that God gave me, so I really don't try to tamper with it too much. There was a point where I reached kind of, like, a pinnacle as far as, like,
plateau.
My brain, like, when I was working on Bold and Beautiful, they had me doing a lot of stuff that I was couldn't really connect with. So at that point, I needed to kind of further my imagination.
Mm-hmm.
But beyond that, I mean, I kind of just gave what God gave me and kind of went forward that way with
what
it.
What would you do? You just got pictures and you sent it to an agent, or did you?
No, that's what I was saying.
Like, what went down?
Nah, I landed at LAX and then I was in a movie. What do you want me to say?
I came off the plane, right?
And then
I was in the damn film. That's what I was saying before you started roasting me. Listen, I had a I heard something on the radio, like, you want to be a star, this whole thing, right? My friend dared me to go do it. So I went to this hotel, and it was like a room full of people, right?
Hold up now.
They're like,
what kind of show is this about to become?
They're like, take your clothes off. I'm like, hold on. Wait a second.
Wait, for real?
No.
Oh. I was like, I've been through that too.
He was like,
Oh, now we can't joke?
Oh, like, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Nah, so I did this, you know, I did this arts program. It's called The Arts, man. Shout out to them. Kind of got my feet wet with that. Met some agents and stuff out there. They told me, come out to L.A. We'll take care of you. You know, I spent a year after that, and I continued playing basketball because I didn't think it was a reality at that time. And there was a point where I was auditioning and auditioned for Divergent, which was a film that came out a couple of years ago. And I was in a running for, like, a lead role in that. And that kind of, like, changed my mind to, like, damn, I can actually do this. So then after that, I kind of packed up and drove from Chicago to L.A. with the bag clothes, and that's all I had.
Oh, you drove.
And yeah. So you just got cast in 10.
Yeah, that just aired on Lifetime. Aired. Shout out to China McClain. You know,
how was that experience? Was that the biggest movie?
No, I wouldn't say that. I mean, I really don't. It's just a different platform. I wouldn't. It's hard to kind of level that because Bold and Beautiful. I mean, they basically have an outreach over millions. Like, you know, internationally, I've been to Europe. I've been, you know, kind of all over the world a little bit with them, and it's a bigger outreach than even in the States. So it's kind of hard to measure those, but. It was different. It was fun. You know, I did this movie with China McClain and Chris Roberts, who directed it, and it was received really well. You know, it was a horror film. I didn't die.
It's cool.
You know,
what
so that was
like the black guy in the
you know,
the
like,
doesn't die.
I'm not dying in this.
I mean, like, you're living the dream of a lot of people. You know, you're living the dream of a lot of actors like, that want to be in your position. What are some lessons that you've learned through this experience?
I think everybody's journey is just different. You know what I mean? Like, we idolize people that we see on TV or we see in, like, in our shoes and stuff, and shoes that we want to be in. So for me, it's not like a dream for me. You know what I'm saying? It's like, it was a dream. Now it's a job. Now it's like lifestyle. Now it's a reality. You know what I mean? And you have to reach those sort of stages in your life. And then that's how you kind of, you keep growing, you know, because there's a lot of people who want to be actors and mm-hmm. do different artistic mm-hmm. things. Right. But at the same time, if you always consider it to be a dream and every time it's like your big shot, your one shot, you'll never get there. Yeah. Like, it just don't happen like that. So
what advice do you give, you know, up-and-coming actors?
Be yourself, man. Right. It's like, that's so cliche.
Everyone
but like,
else is taking.
No, but the real talk is like, no, it's super weird, but like, seriously, like, be yourself. Like, don't try to be me. Don't be nobody else. People love you way more if you was authentic. You know, that's what got me jobs is just being myself. Because here's the thing that people don't tell you in the industry is like, it's word of mouth sort of thing. Like, mm-hmm. people know you from other people. People want to hire you because they want to see who they can be friends with and work with. Because at a certain point, when it's down to 3 or 4 or 5 people, it ain't about talent no more.
Right.
It's about who we
it's
like.
Business.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So
yeah,
they're like, we like him. We like his personality. So they want to work with you over a 2-month, 4-month span. You know what I mean? So just be yourself, man.
So what do you have lined up for the future? What are you working on?
I did a lot of work with Tyler Perry. Shout out to Mr. Tyler Perry. I did a movie with him that comes out next year, Lionsgate.
Nice.
It's called Madea's Family Funeral. It's hilarious.
Oh my God.
This man was like 8 different characters in the movie.
That's
you know, no, but special shout out to Tyler, man, because when I did that movie, the first day I met him, I was kind of like, damn, I don't know how to approach him, you know? And I'm like, hey, how you doing, Mr. Tyler? He's like, hey, how you doing? And he kind of waved me off. I'm like, damn, okay, cool. Then later on, you know, he pulled me aside and he's like, listen, you're great. I want you to do something else with me. I have another show. I'm like, okay, cool. Later, after we finished filming the movie, he called me, like, about, you know, writing this role for me in this show called The Have and Have Nots. He's like, I want to do 10 episodes with you, which we end up doing 25 or
Whoa.
Something like that.
Whoa.
So that comes out next year also. So shout out to Mr. Tyler Perry, man. Straight
That's
up.
Amazing.
And just so people know, Rome can actually hoop.
Rome
can hoop, though.
Can hoop
what
though.
Position
Rome can
play?
Actually hoop. And I don't say that about a lot of people because I can actually hoop.
Okay.
Rome can actually
okay,
hoop.
That's my
false
dog,
news.
Man.
Yo, Rome
no,
can actually hoop.
I,
he be busting people.
It's a thing. Like, it's false. So weird. I was playing in CBA in Compton, and nobody knew what I did. You know what I mean? So when I was hooping, and I was doing work. Like, that's what I did my whole life. You know, so, and then people started catching on. Like, you're an actor, and then people were like, why the hell are you in here, man? Like, what you waiting in Compton for?
Why?
Yeah, because, you know, people try to get away from their circumstances, you know, and I kind of went back to it, you know. Yeah. So, but that's just, like, my competitive nature. But I really do hoop. Like,
are you still hooping?
Yeah.
Where are you hooping?
I'm not hooping on any teams right now.
No, but
now.
I mean, like, where do you go so we can tell the fans?
Don't come up there. Okay.
None of nothing.
At your local gym.
Right.
At your local gym.
I do a lot of, like, celebrity fundraiser games, man. I try to incorporate that and kind of, you know, bring it full circle. Still fun that way for me.
How do you feel about the Cavs roster?
Ooh. I think they're really stacked right now.
Ooh, they got D Wade.
I
don't want that old thing back.
I think Derrick Rose might have a great year this year, man. I think up until January,
he still
you
has
know.
Faith in D Rose.
Aww. Yeah, man. I'm from Chicago.
Yeah,
he's
hey, oh,
D
yeah,
Rose,
I forget
call
the
me,
whole
bro.
Chi-town
I just got that D Rose. Every time you talk about D Rose, I'm like, oh, ACL. Yeah.
He was the truth.
Is he your favorite player?
No. He's not my favorite player, but I respect his game for sure. Yeah.
Wait, who's your favorite team in the NBA?
I really don't have a favorite team. I'm a player kind of guy. Like, I just watch from
players.
I'm a player kind of guy. That was a light-skinned response.
Yeah, man. I like the lightest person on the court is probably the person I like most. Steph Curry. I think he changed the game like Jordan did, man. I think he really now people are saying Curry when they're shooting threes, man.
Right.
It changed the mindset. It changed the mindset of
Kobe.
A lot of kids growing up.
Right. They don't say Kobe.
People don't want to go to the basket. They want to shoot threes now, man. So
that's true.
You know, shout out to Steph.
They say Kobe when they do other things in Denver. Never
mind. That's not funny. This is you guys.
They say Kobe.
Sorry, Vaughn. I'm sorry. But 10. Okay, 10 Murder Island.
10 Murder Island. Just it's on Lifetime.
Lifetime
right now. Actually, watch that.
And real quick, before we go to break, because we have to go to break here in a second, go ahead and let everybody know how they can connect with you, all the fans and the people like that.
You can follow me on Instagram at Rome Flynn, on Twitter at Rome Tremaine. I have a Facebook account, Rome Flynn. So find me.
Rome Flynn on
Rome
all
Flynn,
the
thank you for coming.
Thank y'all for having
good
me, man.
To know.
Man.
Good
it was
to
lit.
Have
it was lit.
My brother, fold up, man.
Appreciate you, brother, for being here.
Thank y'all.
One more time, shout out to WSS. Don't forget to check out at shopwss.com and follow at shopwss.com. What kind of website is that?
Lost.
Go to shopwss.com or follow them at shopwss. And of course, shout out to ESPN for us being here. And don't forget to go on your iOS device and download the Ballers World app. DJ Mystery.
It is.
We'll be back with Chris Staples.
Woo!